Hello friends, welcome back to today's class. So we were discussing your multiple random variables, and in the previous class we have already discussed your various properties of multiple random variables, like the properties for CDF and PDF. So these were the some of the properties of PDF. So please go through the previous video before moving into this video, because this is the continuation of the previous video. Today we will go ahead and discuss some of the new topics, like we'll like to discuss some other properties apart from what has been discussed in the previous video. So in today's class, let us see one very important thing, like how we obtain our volume when we have multiple random variables. Okay, so let us say, for example, you have a region R, and in that region R you have XY plane. You have an XY plane, then you don't know where are your points in this XY plane. You don't know where are your points. So what did we do in the previous class? We were knowing where are our points. That is, say for example, here X was ranging from minus infinity to plus infinity, and Y is ranging from here minus infinity to Y. But now let us say we don't know where are our points, and we just say that we have two points in our XY plane. Okay, so in such scenarios, what we'll consider is, we'll consider that the total region R itself is our region of observation. Okay, so in that case, let us say the probability of P is nothing but probability of both the points XY are belonging to the region R. Okay, in that case we will be integrating, that is both integration, double integration with respect to the region R. So what is the difference, friends? If you observe here, we were integrating in between some limits. We were knowing what are our limits. So but here what is happening? We don't know what is our limit. So in that such cases, we take it as integration of the whole region R. Okay, and as usual, what we will be integrating? We will be integrating our PDF, that is bivariate PDF, okay, with respect to dx and dy. Okay, so the only simple thing here we need to understand here is that if we don't know where our point lies in our xy plane, then we consider the integration for the whole region. Okay, now let us say we have our two points. Okay, like say for example, X is ranging between x1 to x2 and Y is ranging between y1 to y2. Okay, now this scenario you have already come across in your module number 1, wherein we have studied our single random variable. Okay, so if you recall, friends, here I have written your from module number 1 the property for single random variable. So if you can observe here, I have a single random variable X, and this random variable X is in between x1 and x2. It is ranging between x1 and x2. So in that case, what did we take? We took from the lower limit, that is the lower value x1, up to integration up to higher value which is x2. And what we are integrating? We are integrating our PDF with respect to X, which is with respect to X. Okay, now the same scenario, friends, we need to apply it for multiple random variables. We'll extend the same property for multiple random variables. That is, here we had only X, here we have both X as well as Y, both the variables. Okay, so same thing, friends, the lower variable up to the highest variable, fx of x dx, that is single variable PDF. Here we have what now? It is a bivariate PDF, fxy with respect to x comma y, and since we have considered first x, we will write here what now? Dx, that is integration with respect to x. Next is what now? We have taken one more random variable, y. So therefore, again from the lower value up to the higher value integration, again inside integration is what now? Our PDF. But here we will be integrating with respect to y, because our random variable is y. Okay, so always remember, friends, the integration for a single random variable, that is the PDF integration for a single random variable, you will get area under the curve. you'll get the area under the curve. And when you integrate, double integration for a bivariate random variable, that is two random variables, then you get the volume. We'll be getting the volume, and this volume will be present in your xy plane. Okay, and its surface is given by its PDF. So I hope you got the difference. Double integration is nothing but volume. Single integration, that is for SRV, that is single random variable, it is nothing but the area. Okay, so remember this point. So moving ahead, now we'll move to very important concept now, that this has been used, this will be used in your problems as well, in the upcoming problem. So friends, here we will discuss that we can obtain a single random variable. We can obtain a single random variable from your multiple random variables. Okay, not actually multiple random variables, from the probability density functions, from the probability density functions of multiple random variables. Now, what are these probability density functions? We have two probability density functions. One is CDF and another one is PDF. Okay, so from your multiple random variable CDF and PDF, we can obtain our single random variable PDF. We can obtain our single random variable PDF. Okay, so that is what we'll be discussing. So such PDFs which we obtain using our multiple random variable are called as marginal PDF. Okay, so we'll discuss how this could be done now. So say for example, you already have this property, you know this, that is the PDF and CDF form the inverse pair. They are inverse of one another. Like say for example, we can obtain PDF from CDF, we can obtain CDF from PDF. Okay, so suppose you have a PDF and you want your, suppose you have a CDF, sorry, and you want your PDF, then what you do friends, you just differentiate your CDF, you just differentiate your CDF. Okay, so this same concept has been extended to bivariate random variables. Okay, from the properties of bivariate CDF, what we can write now, we'll assume one more variable y, and what is the range of that variable friends? It is infinity. That means what now? It is from minus infinity to plus infinity. We don't know what actually its value, so therefore we just assume it as infinity. And you have already studied in the previous class. In the previous class, let me get back, take you back there. Yeah, so the first property you have seen here, that, sorry, the second property you can say, so fx of infinity is nothing but it's a single variable CDF. So this you have already seen. So the same property we are using here. So this is equal to nothing but fxy of x comma infinity. Now, very important friends, when you have xy, what happens when you have xy? Quite obviously, it is double integration, right? So if you can observe here, when you have xy, quite obviously what it is? It is double integration. So therefore, you can see here, what is the value of range of x now? It is nothing but minus infinity to x. Now, what is the range of y? Range of y is minus infinity to plus infinity. Why? Because we are assuming it. Okay. Next, fxy is nothing but, it is just to avoid confusion, fxy, u comma y, and integration with respect to dy and du. What is du? Du is nothing but, we will be integrating your x. Okay. And what is y? Y is nothing but your dy, and that will be integrating from minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay, so now friends, if you observe here a bit carefully, what will happen? Just I'll take the board. Yeah, so now what will happen friends, please observe. So this, whatever you have, this du and this t by dx and minus x to infinity, so these things get cancelled. You can see here, here you have a variable x, and here also you have a variable x, so therefore it will get cancelled. And here this du is corresponding to what now? It is corresponding to your variable x. So therefore all these three things will be getting cancelled. Okay, next, so this is one thing. So after cancellation, what will be getting friends? After cancellation, it is nothing but minus infinity to plus infinity fx of y, that is, here I have replaced x with u, it's okay. You can write here u all x as well as u, anything is okay, no problem. Okay, so fx comma y dy. So very important friends, this thing, whatever we have written here, it is called as marginal PDF of x. it is called as marginal PDF of x. Now what actually is happening here, please observe, it is nothing but we have obtained your PDF of a single random variable using your multiple random variables. Okay, so and whose PDF it is? It is the PDF of x. It is the PDF of x. Now how to remember this thing? Very simple, friends. How to remember? When you want to find the PDF, that is marginal PDF of x, just integrate your multiple bivariate PDF with respect to other variable. So this you need to remember. I will repeat it once again. Please concentrate. If you want to find the marginal PDF of x, you need to integrate your bivariate PDF with respect to y. If I want x here, I will be integrating with respect to y. Similarly, let us say I want y now. Say for example, I want f of y and here y. Please pardon me for the not so good writing because I will be using mouse. It's a bit difficult to write with the mouse. So this is nothing but f y of y. Okay, so what all things would remain common? This would remain common, that is minus infinity to plus infinity bivariate PDF. Okay, bivariate PDF x comma y. Here you have a xy. Okay, but what changes? This is the only thing which is changing, that is here you will be doing it with respect to x, and this marginal PDF x is nothing but it is marginal PDF of y. Okay, so what all changes we did, friends? This fx of x has become what now? Fy of y. It has become fy of y. And here we are integrating. This thing is same. That is the bivariate PDF is same. Okay, and the change thing is what now? The dy has been replaced with dx. Okay, then it becomes marginal PDF of y. Okay, so in short, let us say I want marginal PDF of y. So if I want marginal PDF of y, say I want marginal PDF of y, then what do I do? I write here fy of y. I'll be writing here fy of y. One more small change here is I'll be integrating with respect to x. Okay, so this is very important, marginal PDF. Based on this, you have some problems. We'll solve them in the next upcoming classes. Next very important topic we have is independence. Okay, so independence, you already studied in your first module, if you remember independence. We have, from first module, we can say that, let us say we have two events, A and B, and these two events are independent. They are not dependent on one another. That is, occurring of A is not dependent on occurring of B, and occurring of B will not be dependent on occurring of A. To give you a simple example, it will rain today, and another example is I will eat food. So eating your food and raining today are not connected to one another. So such events are called as independent events. Okay, so whenever there is an independent event, we write it as something like this. That is nothing but P of probability of A intersection of B. So this is nothing but it is multiplication of their individual probabilities, that is probability of A multiplied by probability of B. Okay, so this was the case when we have a single random variable. So when I say first module, remember friends, it is single random variable. Now how it could be extended for two random variables? Let us say we have two random variables x and y, and these random variables are independent of one another. They are not connected to one another. So in that case, this is how you represent it, that both the bivariate CDF and PDF will be equal to, please concentrate, both the bivariate CDF and PDF will be equal to the product of the separate CDF and PDF respectively. That means the bivariate CDF, let us say first take only bivariate CDF. If you take bivariate CDF, then it is nothing but it is product of their separate CDFs, and if I take bivariate PDF, then it is nothing but product of their PDFs. Okay, so we'll see it in the form of the equation now. So as you can see here, this is nothing but your CDF. So this is bivariate CDF. So this is bivariate CDF. Please connect both the this line and this line. So this is bivariate CDF, and what we have written, this is equal to it is the product of the separate CDFs. So the first variable is what now? X, and its CDF is what? This thing, P of X less than or equal to X. So this is the definition of CDF. I hope you remember it. And similarly for Y, it is P of Y less than or equal to Y. So this is definition of CDF for Y. So what we have done here, it is multiplication of the first CDF, that is of X, and the multiplication of the second CDF, that is Y. So always remember, friends, if I have two random variables X and Y, and if they are independent, then their CDFs can be multiplied. Okay. Similarly, when we speak of PDF, that's what we have done here. The next case is PDF. That's why we have written here respectively. So when we speak of PDF, you already know that PDF and CDF are inverse to one another. So I can obtain my PDF by differentiating your CDFs. So this is nothing but it is, you take a simple differentiation here, d by dx of fx of x, and again differentiate this one, it is d by dy of fy of y. So when you differentiate it, what you get? You'll be getting the PDFs, individual PDFs. So what we obtained, that is bivariate PDF is equal to multiplication of PDF of first variable, which is x, with the multiplication of PDF of the second variable, which is y. Okay, so that means what now? It is fxy is equal to fx of x multiplied by fy of y. So this is regarding your independence. So friends, today we have finished your properties, and we have also finished your independence. So please go through it. In properties, very important thing is marginal PDF, and independence, we will be using independence as well. So have a look at this. In the next class, we will be solving the problems on it. Thank you.